So hi dear Sagittarius, a very good evening to you guys. This is Anjali Tarot and this is a general love reading for all the Sagittarius Sun, Moon, Venus, Rising. Keep in mind this is general, it might or might not resonate with you at the first place. The second thing, the roles can be reversed also. Third thing, this is a reading from 7th till the 13th of October for those who are in complete no contact or no communication and wants to know what's going on the what's going on the other side. If it is not resonating, it's not your story, you can just skip the video, okay? If you want to be a professional tarot card reader like me, you can start your journey by purchasing my course. The link is in the description box for the same. If you want to start your self-healing journey with Ho'oponopono, but don't know from where to start, you can definitely start by purchasing my masterclass. Again, the link is in the description box for the same and it has the power to change your life for the rest of your life. Trust me on that, I'm doing it from a very long time now. And if you want a one-on-one healing sessions or personal readings, you can check out the description box and you can mail me for the same. So let's start. Sagis, the person that you have no contact or no communication with, their current feelings for you right now at this present moment are, let's see. We have the Emperor, the Hierophant and the Six of Cups. Okay, so it's like, yeah, in their mind space we have the Ten of Pentacles. So they're very much focused on money, job, career, financial stability and some kind of stability regarding their family as well. Okay, now in the heart space, this person is holding a lot of space for you, lot of space for this connection. They feel a spiritual level of connection between you and them, and at the same time they feel like they should not show any kind of emotions towards you, towards the situation, because if they are going to do that, it's going to hurt them only. It's like, okay, I am feeling deeply for Sagittarius, I'm loving you, I'm wanting you and I care for you deeply, but when it comes to like, okay, you are in front of me, I behave like I don't give a damn about you, I don't give a shit about you, I don't even know you. So this person is feeling like they should not portray any kind of emotions to you at all. Leave about this energy of expressing to you. This person is not interested in expressing any kind of feelings to you at all, like 0%, even if they feel like they have a lot of love towards you, but they don't want to show it to you, not at all. They want to focus on money, job, career or some kind of family responsibilities, or they feel like they should go ahead with their family's choice when it comes to love and relationship. Take it how it resonates with you. For some of you, if this person is already married, they feel like they should concentrate on their marriage even if they still have love for you. Yeah, let's see what this person wants from you. What are their intentions for the situation between you and them, Sagis? We have the Three of Swords, the Eight of Pentacles, the Seven of Cups. Wow. Page of Wands. This person wants to keep their options open, keep their energies open towards new people, new experiences, new things, new situations, because this person is so heartbroken, so sad, so depressed about whatever happened between you guys. Now they want to put in the effort and energy in distracting themselves as much as they can by keeping their options open, or by keeping as many options in their life as they can, so that they are not going to feel the heartbreak that they experienced or that they are feeling. Okay, so in order to cover their heartbreak, to cover their pain, this person wants to put in the effort and energy in this energy of, okay, let's have multiple options, multiple choices, multiple things, and let's distract myself to the level of not even thinking about Sagittarius at all. Okay. Let's see what action is this person going to take towards you, if any, by the 13th of October. We have the Page of Swords, the Two of Pentacles, the Empress. I do see this person being going back and forth about the situation between you and them. See, I don't see them taking any kind of action, to be honest. For some of you, there are slight chances that this person is going to connect with you, then they are going to disconnect with you again. Like the moment they are going to connect, then they are going to realize that they should not be connecting with you anymore, or they might be dealing with something else or someone else. They're going to disconnect as fast as they're going to connect. For others of you, they're going to be so much in their head about what should I do, they are going to end up doing nothing about it, and they're going to be like, okay, let's focus on my job, my career, my everything, my growth and expansion, and we will think about Sagittarius later on. So for those of you who are getting the communication, it's going to be short-lived. It's going to be like today they're communicating, the next day they're like they don't give a shit about you. So I don't see a flow of communication happening, and they're going to be too stressed out about why the hell I connected to Sagittarius, why. So they are going to be like, okay, losing their mind, losing their shit, and they're going to disconnect as fast as they're going to connect. Okay, let's see the guidance for you guys, Sagittarius, in the situation. We have the Chariot. Okay, keep moving on. Sagittarius, this person, this situation is kind of not meant for you, at least for the timing. This situation is highly, highly on and off, in and out, highly immature, highly unstable, actually. This is the right word. So it's better not to like ruin your energy, waste your energy and timing on something that's not sure about you, or something that's not making you feel happy, or something that's not giving you something stable on the table. Okay, it's not recommended to do that. It's highly recommended to move on and keep moving on until you find the right kind of match or right kind of energy that's meant for you, that's good for you, that's actually productive and good for you. Okay, so yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, Sagis. I'll see you soon in the next video. Bye bye, take care, God bless you. Namaste.